In a previous video, Russell Bell provided an overview of the BYOL process for Amazon Workspaces, and in that video, he demonstrated installing Windows on a VMware workstation. In this video, I will walk you through how you can do the same using Hyper-V to create a BYOL image. With that, I'm Dave Jasky, Senior Solution Architect with AWS, focusing on end-user compute. Let's jump in. For today's agenda, we'll start by creating the virtual machine within Hyper-V. Next, we'll install Windows 11. After that, we'll configure the virtual machine for export. And then following that, we'll walk through the next steps and a future video on how to get this uploaded into Amazon Workspaces. So the first thing we're going to do is open up our Hyper-V console. We'll click on New Virtual Machine. Within the first window, we'll click Next. And we'll specify the virtual machine name. For this, we'll just enter BYOL, click Next. For this, we'll select Generation 2, since we're installing Windows 11. If you're using Windows 10, you can use Generation 1. For the startup RAM, we'll leave it as the default value and click Next. And for the connection, we'll leave it as not connected. Now we'll add a hard disk. For this, it's very important that it be less than 80 gigs. So for this, I'll enter 70 gigs and click Next. For the installing the OS, we'll go and get our ISO that we downloaded previously and select that, and that will initiate the Windows install once we power up the machine. In the file screen, we'll see the summary and click Finish. This will initiate the setting up of the virtual machine. And as we can see now, it's in the console ready to be booted up. Before installing Windows 11, there's a few settings that need to be updated. For this, we'll go into the virtual machine settings and click down on security. Under encryption support, we'll enable the trusted platform module and leave the rest of the settings default. Next, we'll go over checkpoints. As part of the virtual machine export process, we'll need to export the virtual disk. To simplify the process, we'll disable the checkpoints on this virtual machine, as we're just going to be installing Windows, running a few checks on it, and then exporting it. The rest of the settings can be left as default, and we'll click Finish and Apply. Now we're ready to begin the Windows 11 install. For this, I'll click on the virtual machine and click Connect. Now I'll start it up. And when I start it up, I'll get this screen that you get on any desktop or laptop that's asking you to hit any button to boot off the DVD drive. The rest of this process will be answering Windows questions to complete the installation. In our previous video, Russell Bell completes these steps for VMware. They're the exact same for Hyper-V. Once you complete the Windows installation and run the BYOL checker, we'll get the VHDX information upload to S3. Completing the Windows install and running the BYOL checker, we need to get the hard disk location. That's located in Settings and under the hard disk. Copy this path for future steps to upload S3. In this video, we set up Hyper-V for creating the BYOL image. In addition, after the installation was complete, we copied the path of the VHDX file that will be uploaded to S3 in our next video. Thank you for watching, and hope to see you in our next video.